Welcome back to Let's Play the Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. We've just arrived in Gadonil. Almost got lost in the ruins, but we did get lost for a little bit as we were talking about with this soldier. This is Gadonil, a town of free trade. Stay for a while, enjoy.
Stay a while and listen.
Are you hungry? No. Okay. Ah. Hello. Can I walk back here with him? No. Okay. Razumu says, welcome, welcome. Come and see. We have many goodbyes here. How do I actually see what you're selling? Never mind then. I wanted to collect from the bunny. Peruta says, walk along this street and you'll find almost everything you need. You can get whatever you want because this is a town of free trade. Mm-hmm. You've got fruits and stuff. Panima says, let's see, what do I want for dinner? This town always has many street vendors selling a variety of goods. I have a hard time choosing. Hi. Let's not talk to him yet, because he's a required person. Would you like to hit those ones last? Because sometimes things change after you talk to them. I want to explore this place first, not get stuck into some possible cutscene or something. Did we actually buy anything from any of these people? Afuru says, come and take a look. We have everything from fresh vegetables and fruits to pottery. Alright, well I guess I can't buy any of that stuff. Richika says, I came here to buy tools for my store. It's so convenient they have a dealer in this town. But I wish the dealer gave us a little more of a discount. Hmm. Do you wish that? Teneru says, I'm looking for something delicious. I don't think these street vendors sell figs. Hi. Come on, you folks. If you're not in a hurry, stop by and take a look. We have various fruits from around the world, including mangoes from a southern country and ripe papayas. Hey, young man, why don't you come in and take a look? I know you'd rather see a lady bathing, but you'd have to climb up the chimney of a bathhouse. Don't give him any ideas. Badat says he's in high spirits. Okay. I thought this was a wall from back here. What'd you find? I don't need that. Alright, we got weapons here. Possibly armor. Boulay, the arms dealer, says, hi there. All our weapons are of the highest quality. If you carry a weapon from my shop, you'll be okay even when attacked by monsters in the desert. Okay. Well, we're getting a lot of new swords. Sword of Winds. But it's not as good. The attack goes down, the avoidance goes up. Sorcerer's Staff, I believe that's what Chris has. Sword of Wind says, a magic sword surrounded by a whirlwind. Wow, sounds interesting. Oh, didn't mean to leave. Steel Knuckles, Badat already has. Victor's Fist for Badat, right? Attack goes up to... from 215 to 223. Knuckle Dusters blessed by the God of Duels, reinforced with steel inlays. Well, that's like a good investment for him. A robust shield for Yurio. Shaped like a turtle shell, this shield is heavier and harder to use than it looks. Interesting. So Yurio's defense would go from 129 to 132. Not a hell of a lot, but... And, Badat, yeah. The Budo Vest. I think we can sell that? We didn't sell that, did we? We got him a new vest. Fleeting robes. We don't need that. Gauntlets. Badat's already wearing that. I guess that's giving if he put on a second one. Alright, let's do the exchange. I know how much we're dealing with here. Let's buy... the Sword of Winds. Wait, not the Sword of Winds. Is it? Wait. His attack... 264. Wait. His attack goes down. I don't like that. But his avoidance goes up to 39. Well, let's get the Victor's Fist for Badat then. We'll have to figure out some what we want to do. Come again. Okay. Attack going from 215 to 223. Let's sell a couple things. I wish these were divided and more separated into different categories. Yeah, he's the Master Sword. Or he had the Master Sword. Let's sell the Spider Knife. Disarming opponent. You know, I'm gonna keep that just in case. Let's sell the Steel Knuckles. And the Budo Vest. And the Fleeting Robes. Wow. I'll keep one. Robust shield, right, for your area. I'm undecided about that sword. I mean, maybe it just has a special attack. It's an awful lot. Plus, technically, at this point, we don't have enough, but we're gonna sell something, right? Let's, yeah, large shields. His defense goes from 129 to 132. Large shield. Yeah, I think I'm gonna skip on that sword. Okay. Hello there. Sometimes if you go behind the counter, they say other things to you. But not in this case. Let's see if they have any new food. Probably not. Yeah. May the chapel... what does it say? May the chapel bring you blessings? May the chapel spell bring you blessings. Which one? There are a whole lot of chapel spells. Hello there. Sarudi says, hi there. Have you come to this town to purchase stock for your store? We only have one room left. You can use it if you like. Badat says, you mean it's free? This inn caters to merchants who come here to buy stock. You can stay free of charge. That won't hurt my business. Don't worry. Yo-Yo says we must rescue Chris as soon as possible. Yeah. Plus, that means we're not gonna be staying here. Tonizu says, have you come here to purchase stock for your store or anything? Godonal has such a large market, it's easy to find things I need. If you have problems deciding what to buy, I can give you advice. I have a trained eye. Alright. Begin your advice. Except you won't. If I talk to him from this side, same thing. Yeah. Hi. Juman says, I hear a man named Kandata is visiting Woolghit's mansion from Baraka. I'm sure they're plotting an evil deed. Not many rich people have a good heart. You be careful. Hoi. I can't go back there. Isuli says, welcome. This is a retail tool shop for general consumers. Okay, tools meaning potions. Oh, Safi Volume 9. Avenging Blade, yes. Let's take a look at that. Avenging Blade. Safi waited motionlessly for King Topaz to come down from his throne. If you were a man, I could employ you as a court swordsman, said the king in a friendly tone as he approached Safi. Looking at the saber, the king murmured, Silfing. And his voice faded. What does that mean? There had been a swordsman who masterfully handled this famous sword at will. His talent brought him closer to the secret of the royal family, and ultimately died with obvious cause. It was King Topaz himself who gave the order to kill him. Realizing something was wrong with the king, soldiers ran toward him. However, her saber was already at the king's throat. Her eyes turned into cold, burning gemstones. They kept on burning in the flames of hatred. All she needed was to take a step forward, and she could kill the man who ordered the death of her father. When she saw herself in the aged eyes of the king, she remembered what Brad said, "Hatred in the sword will bring you down." Hatred awakens more hatred. What Safi had been fighting against was the burning, blue hatred inside her. Safi quietly put the silfing into the sheath and walked off slowly. No one else moved. Her eyes gradually turned into tranquility like the surface of a lake. Swordswoman Safi, end. Sweet! We found all the volumes. Okay. Let's to the mansion. See if there's anything else around here to look at. Anyone else to talk to? Maybe that's the mansion. Or maybe they both are. Oops. Oh! Recure potion, thank you. Farron says, we must bring a gift to enter Woolghit's mansion. He's so greedy. Please don't tell anyone I spoke ill of him. I'll be in trouble if the soldiers find out about it. Sounds like a wonderful person. Sarugio, the tool dealer, says, hi there. We are tool dealers who work for the wealthy merchant Woolghit. Which store are you representing? Yo-Yo says, what? Which store? Oh, you're not dealers. This place is where merchants buy and sell their goods. We don't do retail sales. I think you came to the wrong store. Badat says, then why don't you say that on the door? Don't be angry. We only deal with retailers. There is a tool shop for general consumers on the northwest side of town. Northwest. And we just went there, didn't we? Excuse me. Hmm. Alright, let's go there again. Because I think we have to buy a gift for Woolghit. Northwest? Well, she just sells food for pets. I think they mean this guy over here. Oh, well. Sweet. You can pass if you want. This is a country of free trade. Anyone can get in and out freely. Okay, I'm guessing that just leads outside, but this goes to Woolghit's mansion over here. Who are you? This is the mansion of Master Woolghit. The general public is prohibited from entering. I can let you pass if you have a valuable gift, but Master Woolghit is difficult to please. I don't see anything that might please Master Woolghit. Well, we didn't actually lay everything out in front of you, did we? I can't give you permission to enter. I am a proud guard protecting the mansion of Master Woolghit. Alright. We have to get a gift. Here we go. Badat says, we need a gift to get inside. Let's rest in the room and think about what to bring. Yeah. Thanks. We'll take the room. There's somebody in that room. Yo-Yo says, I have an idea. All the people here are buying merchandise. They may know of some rare commodity that will impress the gatekeeper at Woolghit's. You're right. Why don't we ask the people in the next room, Badat says. That's not the next room, that's the same room. Tanuso says, yes, may I help you? We have a question, says Yurio. What is the most precious commodity anyone in this country would want at any price now? Oh, you want my advice on buying? Let me see. There are many precious commodities in the world, but right now, the hot item is figs. Badat says, figs? They're precious? Yeah, big time. This year we had a bad crop of figs for some reason. We can't find any on the market. The people of Godona love figs. I think they'd buy figs at any price. If you find figs, you can make people very happy. Badat says, so if we bring figs, will Woolghit let us enter his house? Of course. Wealthy people are gastronomes. I'm sure he'll be ecstatic. That's a very complicated word for you, sir. Well, how do we find figs, then? Stay for a while and enjoy. Yeah, let's get some rest here. I have an itch on my back. Hold on. Hold on 1 second. Oh, yeah. That's it. I'm trying to scratch an itch, and my hair is itching it even more. Mostly got it. Alright, no. We can't ask him. Oh. Don't tell me you bought figs. Nope. Full mind potion. I'm wondering how many of those I have right now. Eight of them, wow. Oh. Make that nine. We're almost full. I don't suppose there's any figs here. There was somebody who was asking about figs. But let's talk to these people first. Okay. He's not helpful. We must bring a gift to enter Woolghit's mansion. He's so greedy. We don't have an option. Oop, didn't mean to hit that again. Okay. Isn't he stopping us, like, back more before? I missed an item from the rabbit again. Oh! Ah, we're full of full cure potions. Oh, the mind potion's what we're missing. Oh! You sell figs? Do you have figs? Yurio asks. Figs? Sorry, no chance. We had a bad crop of figs this year. You seldom see them lately. How about apples? They're delicious. No. Don't need apples. Peruta says, wow, Godola is located right in the middle of a desert, yet it is full of stuff. Woolghit must be a powerful person. This guy, and this guy was looking for figs, I think it was him. They must have had a very bad crop. Oh, I wanted so much to eat figs. Alright, let's talk to him. Come and take a look. We have everything from fresh vegetables and fruits to pottery. Badat says, you said you have everything. Do you have figs? Huh? You said you have everything. Don't pick on me. Yo-Yo says, so you don't have them? We had a poor crop of figs. Now even we merchants can't eat them at all. Hmm. This guy. Hey, do you sell figs? Yo-Yo asks. Figs? No such luck, young man. We had a bad crop of figs this year. We'd be lucky if we could get a few figs in town in any given month. Badat says, Yo-Yo, all this looking for figs has made me thirsty. Don't they have a well somewhere? Let's drink some water. Yeah, the well's right in the center. Okay, we're there. Ah, that's good. Maybe there's a fig drop down in there. Yo-Yo says, actually, we don't have time to drink water. We must quickly find figs and enter Woolghit's house to rescue Chris. Well, we gotta stay hydrated or we're no help to Chris, are we? But we may not find figs no matter how hard we look, Badat says. We better look for some other rare commodity. Yo-Yo says, if there is another rare commodity. A woman's voice says, Yo-Yo. Yes? Whoa! Oops! I didn't mean to take it, but I did! Could this be a bomb again? Is it a fig? What should I do? What should I do? Badat says, throw it into the well! Right! Wait! The woman says. It's not a bomb. What? Yeah, here's what's her name. Najee? Why are you here? I have the same question, Badat says. That's not important now. Just take a look at what you have closely. It wasn't a bomb. Yo-Yo was carrying a fig. Wow, it's a fig, says Badat. Yo-Yo says, I'm glad I didn't throw it away. But how come you're here? Asks Badat. This place attracts too much attention. We should go somewhere else. Okay, let's go to our room at the inn, says Yo-Yo. And there we go. I followed you. Why? Says Yo-Yo. I was worried because you went to see Woolghit all by yourselves. He is the villain of villains. I couldn't just sit there in my home while you went, so I followed you. Badat says, don't worry, we're fine. If you're worried about Yo-Yo, he's safe with me. I can beat up a villain or two easily. Me too. Easily. What courageous men you are. I know Woolghit doesn't see anyone without a gift. That's why I found figs, the rarest commodity in Godona now. Can we have them? Yo-Yo says. Of course. Use them and rescue Chris as soon as possible. Thanks, says Badat. They found figs. How did you find them? Says Yo-Yo. The vegetable farms for merchants had a bad crop, but you can find one or two natural fig fields. Let's go and rescue Chris. Are you coming with us, Najee? Says Yo-Yo. I don't know, Badat says. We don't know what mean tricks Woolghit may wind up using. We can't put Najee in danger. No, you can't come with us. Yo-Yo says, you're right. Why not? She says, I understand. I think she's the panther, the desert panther anyway. Then I'll wait for you in this room. That's a good idea, says Badat. Yo-Yo, we should leave at once. Okay. Najee, thank you for the fig. Or figs. With it, we can enter Woolghit's mansion. She knows that. Just explain that. Please take care of yourselves. Villain of villains. Like in the beginning of Shining in the Darkness for Sega Genesis Mega Drive, they called him the Fiend of Fiends. Oh, it's a fig! How'd you get hold of it? I'm sure Master Woolghit will be pleased to see it. You have permission to enter. You may enter. That's the whole permission thing is about. Let's see if it says anything. Precious, naturally grown figs. Okay. Yo-Yo says, we should hide our faces in case we bump into Kandana. Right. Okay. We are so hidden. Yeah, there's a door there. A Lego wall. Oh, in another area. Any more merchants? Tandoru says, I hear Kandana from Baraka has been staying in Master Woolghit's mansion. I'm sure they're plotting an evil deed. He's the boss of many merchants, so whenever he has time, he's thinking about new taxes that can make merchants richer. Doesn't he know we pay enough taxes already? What are we doing in here? There's nothing in here. So, this isn't the mansion yet then? Ranba says, I can't speak ill of Master Woolghit, but I hear he's holding the girl Kandana brought from Baraka prisoner in the northwest room. That's not right, you know. I'm sure he'll train her to become a dancer. Oh boy. The northwest room is heavily guarded. All the rooms in the back have stone walls. Even the desert panther can't blow them up with her famous bombs. We'll see about that. She might come to our rescue again. Nothing in here. Iruka says, they say Master Woolghit is a cold guy, but he wasn't this heartless before. Godona became like this around 6 months ago. I don't know how it happened. Alright, anything else to see in here before we advance to the next area? I think we've talked to everybody. Wow. Wow. Let's look around a little. Northwest room is the guarded one. Can't get in there. I like how the footfalls change. Pagia says, I'm taking care of Master Woolghit. Who are you? We're travelers, Badat says. We came to greet him. I see. I have a question for you. Yes? The girl Kandata brought from Baraka, is she safe? Chris, you mean? Yeah, says Yurio. She's locked up in a room just like this one on the west side. I'm sure she's all right. Did you come here to rescue her? Yes, says Yurio. Badat says, shut up. Yurio, what are you doing? Don't worry, he says. I think she's a good person. Oh, thanks. I won't tell anyone, so don't worry. Please rescue Chris if you can. If we can. Must be Woolghit over there, so wait. We talked to her, right? Wow. There's Chris. Let's look around a little. If there's anyone around here to talk to. Oops. Alright. Saving. Because who knows what's going to happen, right? This is Master Woolghit's room. Please wait here. What's the nature of your visit? Yurio says, we obtained a rare treat, so we would like to present it to Master Woolghit. Oh, really? You're lucky. Master Woolghit is here now. You may enter. Badat says, he's so impetuous. First, we must find out if Chris is okay. Hello? Woolghit is eating something. What do you want? I am busy. Give me your gift and tell me what you want, quickly. Yurio says, well, we... Yurio, look at the plate in front of him. He's eating. The plate in front of Woolghit had a heap of figs on it. Figs, Yurio says. Yeah? What about figs? Badat says, the one fig we brought won't help now. But it says figs in our inventory. We got a few. I see. You must be surprised about the figs, right? Since you saw them, I'll tell you the secret. It's a complete lie that we had a bad crop of figs. I bought up all figs and hid them. If there are no figs, their price will skyrocket. I'm a genius. Badat says, so that's what happened. Anyway, what did you bring me? Show me at once. Badat says, we can't show him figs. Yurio says, Mr. Woolghit, what do you think we brought you? Well, from the way you're keeping me in suspense, it must be something very rare. Just show me. Here it is, says Yurio. What? You must be joking. Woolghit picked up the fig Yurio placed in front of him. It's just a fig. No. It is a... Well, how should I put it? Yeah, that's it. It's a rare fig which will make you 10 years younger. Really? Are you sure? Is it really? Says Badat. But yeah, for a while, Yurio says. Badat says, okay. Fine, I'll eat it right away. Munch, munch. They're delicious. Hey, something is happening. I think it's working. Come on, please, says Badat. They're working! Woolghit says, "Humph. Of course it is not. Forget the joke and give me your real gift." "Uh-oh," they say. "Don't tell me you haven't brought anything other than that miserable fig. If that's the case, I'll kill you right here." Yurio and Badat are trembling in fear. Badat says, "Can we forget the whole thing? It was a joke." "Right," says Yurio. "I knew you'd figure it out." Badat says, "By the way, what is it that you want to have most right now?" "Well, I doubt there's any point in telling you, but I'm curious about some gemstones in Menarth called the Crimson Fires. They say these gemstones are very rare and only found in the Tagura Mines." "We can't get those? That's all the way back." "Oh," says Yurio. "What is it?" Yurio says, "I have one." "Oh, we do?" "I have one with me." That's a... Woolghit held the Crimson Fire in his hand. It must have been forever ago we got that thing. Yeah, they're like the diamonds, you know, some kind of gem that explodes if you don't, like, if it gets too big or something, if it's been too old. Woolghit says, "It's real. It's very beautiful." Badat says, "Where on earth did you get it?" Yurio says, "I visited Menarth on our way, and someone gave it to me." "I see." Woolghit says, "It's magnificent. I haven't seen one before, but from its glow I can tell you for sure it's genuine. It's shinier than I thought." Badat says, "So could we ask you a favor in return?" "What do you want?" "You have a girl named Chris Can... You have a girl named Chris Kandana and Baraka brought here. The girl is our friend. Release her to us."
"Chris?"
"Oh, the girl Kandana brought here. He said I could make her a dancer."
"Dancer?" says Yurio.
"Huh. That doesn't sound right." "I have the same feeling," Woolghit says. "She's stubborn and doesn't obey my orders. That's why I locked her up." Badat says, "So you release her, right?" "Let me think." Kandana says, "Master Woolghit, wait."
"Uh-oh."
"Wait. These guys came for that girl. That means..." Badat says, "Oh no, it's Kandana." "Show us your faces," Kandana says. "Whoa." He took the veils off Yurio and Badat. "I remember you. They must be working for the Desert Panther. They were at my house when it was destroyed." "Really?" says Woolghit. Yurio says, "It's a misunderstanding." Badat says, "We don't know anything about the Desert Panther." Kandana says, "Your denials make me more suspicious. I ordered my men to make you fight at the Colosseum. How did you get here?" Woolghit says, "It doesn't matter. So you're working for the Desert Panther, that detestable wench who plots against me? I will never let you go. Soldiers, arrest them. Lock them up and assign a guard." "Oh no," says Badat. Yurio says, "We were so close."